But maybe they're cranky with me. Maybe they're grumpy because I haven't finished making them some decent apartments. So that's what I'm going to do now. I am going to... Guys, the lights downstairs are going to go off again, I'm afraid. I'm unplugging everyone. That's probably a bit of a weakness, isn't it? It's, I unplug a bit of the... You know, I probably shouldn't worry about things like that too much. It's hardly like that's going to be a regular occurrence, is it? You're hardly going to get one of the maintenance staff saying, I was busy moving entire corridors and the lights went off. Oh, and I'm the type of guy who will never settle down. Where pretty girls are, well, you know that I'm around. It would seem settlers become very confused when you remove floors. They don't seem to be able to find their way down without them. However, we'll figure a way to get this guy down there later on. I have been a little busy clearing some of the passages from up here and making some plans. Indeed, I got a piece of paper out and drew squares on it and mapped out a way to have three single apartments and three double apartments, and was very pleased with myself until I realized I had not taken into account doors from below. And so this door, for example, was right in the middle of a room. So every time someone opened the door below, a door would have come rushing into the room here. So I have to rethink. I also thought to myself, you know what? I never did check to see if there were doors coming up in my apartment. And you can probably tell by the way I've removed a few things. I found that this was in fact the case, including... The corridor in. If you remember, originally, you would come up from the overseer's office, you would run past the loadout room, as I'm calling it, through there, and enter the hallway through a door here. It would seem there is a door there, making that kind of stupid. So I've had to move that across, and I've been checking the door situation all round, and I realized there was a door below a door in here, and so on. So, I've started ripping things up and rethinking. I also realized that my apartment was taking up a lot of real estate that could possibly be used for apartments if I do it well. I'm not totally sure yet. So, what I think I'm going to try and do is have my apartment on two levels. I'm going to have the main room here, this will be the living room with a dining room, and a kitchen, I think. I think I will have a kitchen here. Not quite there, but there. And I'm probably going to extend this one over. So this will be an L-shaped room with a kitchen in that corner. And there will be an upstairs. I have a stairway. This will go to a hallway with a bedroom and a... What else did I need? A bedroom? Bathroom! I needed a bathroom. I may also have a spare bedroom for companions. You know, I mean, I realize Codsworth does not require a bed. However, if I'm here with some of the others, they might want somewhere to stay. So I'll probably make a spare bedroom. You almost certainly noticed all the lights are off down there. That is because the lights down there were receiving their power from conduits that I placed along here. I'm going to need to fix the apartments before we get lights down below.
Glad I'm in here and not out there.
You're not in here. Well, I suppose you're in a cave. You are moving around. I'm seeing you move around. Therefore, you can move around and you can make it back in here. Oh, is it because you have to jump? I wonder if that's it. I wonder if it's because he has to jump that he's having some trouble. What would happen if I just placed another random piece in there? Would you suddenly realize you could... Let's make it a four-way. That way he's got access from any direction.
I just can't lose.
Okay. See, now you don't have to jump. Now you can walk. I'm probably going to remove that, but I'll leave it there for now. Oh, I tell you what I also realized, I'm beginning to suspect. The problems I'm having here, I think, due to the way I've done this corner. Because I got very creative and managed to find a way of placing a window piece in a corner, which is something that's not easy. You have to place them in the right order with the right things around them and then put pieces back. It was a pain, but it can be done. I'm beginning to think that is just not something you're supposed to do at all. If it's difficult to achieve, you probably shouldn't do it, although that goes against my very nature. If I continue to have issues with people getting stuck in this area here, what I might do is remove this window piece and remove this and replace it with a wall piece. I don't want to do that because I don't want to lose the metal edge here, but I don't... Oh, actually, I already have a metal edge here.
This is delicious.
Easiest job I ever had.
I suppose I could have the metal edge there, but then it won't match the non-metal edge here. And honestly, the idea of moving this one... Oh, that does not fill me with joy. I don't want to move... I want to move as little as humanly possible. Now, I could use a piece that's got a built-in roof. Actually, I might need to do that. In which case, there would be no wall. It would... Well, no metal thing along the wall. There would also be no... Oh, wait a minute. No. I could place a floor piece there. Well, there'd be no metal lining at the bottom of the wall, and I don't like that. So I'm going to rethink that a teeny bit. But I suspect that might be the reason they're having problems. We'll have to see if they continue to have problems. For now, I think I'm actually going to focus on my apartment. That might sound selfish. Just make the residence! Make the settlers their residences for... Oh, we got a new resident. We got a new settler. Hey, how did you get up here so quickly? Never mind. I'll sort your jumpsuit out and Pip-Boy later. But the reason I want to do my residence is once I do that, I will free up some space here, which could make my life a little easier when doing the planning. So that is what I'm going to do. I'm essentially going to rip everything apart here and make my two-story apartment. One thing I could have done is have apartments above the overseer's apartment, I suppose. I don't like that idea for some odd reason. I don't know why. Although, I still think it's going to be easier to place everybody if I keep the overseer's stuff very, very localized. I think this works. We've got the hallway, we've got the living area. It's not quite L-shaped, a little squish, but I think it's big enough to have a TV, a sofa, and a dining table. We've got the kitchen that has a power source, although that's mainly there to power upstairs. We've got stairs. I decided not to have the stairs right at the door because it actually feels like you're banging your head when you come down. If you have a door right here, you kind of feel like you're going to smash your head. So I decided to not do that. And then I've got two bedrooms. This is the main bedroom, I guess. This is the bigger one, and an ensuite bathroom, and then there is a second bedroom. This is a little small. It's not... I mean, it's barely a room, really, isn't it? It's like a corridor with enough space for a bed. It's not wonderful. The other option was to have a door there. We could share a bathroom. I just couldn't figure a way of doing that and keeping the space small, because I wanted it to sort of not go very... far. I would have actually liked to have had the bathroom there, but there is not really a lot of space. I played with some ideas of having a hallway and then you go into the bedrooms and the bathroom, but they ended up taking up more room than having two bathrooms, or at least as much room, and I had to use domestic pieces. And I want to use as little of these as possible because they do feel like you've stepped outside your apartment slightly. You've got no options when it comes to stairs. So if you want a two-tiered apartment, you have to do this. So in a way, this is almost like two tiny apartments here, really. This is actually the overseer's apartment. This is going to be his bedroom and his bathroom. This is going to be whoever, you know, like Deacon's bedroom and... bathroom. So that's pretty much the same as the residents have got. The difference is we also have an overseer's I don't know what you'd call it, living area and kitchen. He has his own private dining area, and this is probably a good idea, as I will be, you know, wining and dining dignitaries from Diamond City and God knows where. So that would be essentially the use for this. Yes, I'm coming up with reasons for why the Overseer needs twice as much living space as everyone else, in spite of the fact that, let's face it, this particular Overseer is never actually going to live here. Still, you know. Now I've got the outside sorted, I can now take a second look at the residence level and see how much space I've got to play around with. And I think I've got a bit more now. I have, look at this. The only worry I have at the moment is the bit of the kitchen is unsupported, but there's no actual way of getting supports there. None of the supports fit from the top area. I don't think it's too big a problem because it is metal, there's girders, you know, it should support itself to some degree. That's a very small room, and I'm not storing things like power armor and jumping up and down on it. But I'll have to remember this if I build, you know, the apartments for other people. Again, it should support them, that they are metal floors. Now what I have to do is try to come up with a sort of layout for them. I think the first thing to do is to sort out the stairway upstairs, because that's going to block off some more of this and will give us some corridors. I'm not sure where the apartments are going to be exactly yet. Let's just use normal pieces for now. Probably a T-junction here. I mean, I can't imagine not having a T-junction there, because I've got a feeling... Oh, my... No. That's not necessarily true, is it? In fact, it's probably not true. So let's just stick with a corner for now. And just go with straight pieces until we know for sure we want a door. Then we can replace that piece with a door. Yet another corner.
Slot machine. It's no, the not the way.
Thank you. And again, let's just go with a corner piece for now. I suspect I'll want at least a T at this end, because we... Well, it's going to depend on what I put over there, but I think I will. Actually, you know what? I'm absolutely certain I'm going to need a T this piece, because I do want some doors. And therefore, I'm going to have a corridor here, probably. Let's put a T in anyway. It gives me access. It does give me access, and that is always a good thing as well. Hallway with a doorway. No, too far. T. Then I need more stairs up. Come on. Like so, and then a single landing piece there. Do I need the landing piece? That's what I've used down there, isn't it? I've not got the four immediately. I'm wondering if I should perhaps have, so that it's more like, oh god. Actually, yes. 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 Let's see how this works. I often find, like, that kind of thing to be a little intimidating as a drop.
Just can't lose.
It does, of course, leave a little more... Let's have a think here. If I were to have... I don't actually think so. I think I liked...
You gotta try this.
I liked it extending a little.
Best.
Let's have a look how we did it down there. So we can keep some semblance of consistency. Oh, no. No, no. Down here, we had a T-junction, which opened like so. And I did like that. I mean, I could actually... I could actually have just made that a standard... No, I like that. That actually feels nice and open. I may even do the same thing again right here. just to give it a feeling of being open. Although I was also thinking of having a hallway here, probably starting at this point. Okay, let's.
You gotta try this this slot machine.
Yeah.
It's the best.
I can't remember what I put Clem to work on. I think it's the soda machine, to be honest. Which I figured he couldn't do that much damage there. You know, I mean, could he? Really? But he seems to be spending his entire time playing the slot machine. And yet another T. The three-way there. Come on. So that's consistent with what we've got down below. And I'll probably... this depends what I'm going to do and where I'm going to do it. Which in itself sounded a tiny bit rude. One of the things I was thinking was to have a small hallway here. I want a tiny open area on each floor above this one, above the atrium, that has like a vending machine maybe. Just so people can get a quick snack or a cola in the middle of the night. Maybe some of those wall-mounted vending machines, that type of thing, and have that on each level. I also want to have a laundrette. And I was actually thinking a communal bathing area. The apartment I've got down here is probably going to be fairly typical of the single apartments, and it is big enough to eventually perhaps put a shower in if I find a way to add showers. I don't like the baths. I can't stand the bath. I mean, they look so out of place. I can't believe there are not better baths. Maybe I'm missing them, but you would have thought they'd be the same place as this bathtub. We've got nothing like that here. We also don't have any clean ovens. I mean, that's something I really would like, and I'd like them to actually be craft stations as well, but they're not. I really feel like that's something that's quite seriously missing. I'm sure I can, find a way to acquire those items, but that will happen eventually. I mean, I'm not going to obsess too much about the decorations and the furniture at the moment. I want the basics in. But I want the rooms ready for when we start to expand the kind of furniture we have. And you're probably going to find that some apartments don't have space for a shower. And maybe not even this one, for all I know. I mean, it might not work. And so it might be a good idea if I have one room on this side and one room on that side that has ladies' showers and one room that has a gent shower. Something that's just a 4x4 room, a place where I'll start off with a bunch of sinks so people can do some communal cleaning. I only need the laundrette on one side, and I think I'll make it on that side because we've got a classroom and a gym on this side. So, to start off, let's have a think. I was thinking single rooms on this side. Now, the single rooms will be 3x2 plus a... okay. I wanted two spaces for the bathroom, if possible. But that would mean another single room would have to go here. But this doorway kind of makes that impossible, which... unfortunately, I can't actually build anything more down there. These girders get in the way. Unfortunately, that kind of makes this not work, that door. So how could I get around that? I could, of course, have a double room on this side, which I was going to have as 4x2 plus 2 for the bathroom area. That would leave two on this side. That's not going to work either. I could use this space for the aforementioned communal washing areas. Although I've just realized, even if I do make a 2x2 room, I've got to make two of them, plus an entrance, because obviously you don't want the door opening up and showing all these naked people showering. So it's going to... It would take this entire block up. And I have to say, I don't think I'm going to want one of those each side. That's just fairly... Well, that's rather a lot, isn't it? I almost feel like what I should do is have lots of individual showers. The problem is I don't even know what sort of showering equipment I can possibly get for this place. So I was just going to make a 2x2 room using the clinic tiles, and then I could pretty much do whatever I wanted. I am going to put a... probably a 4... a 2x4 room here, plus a bathroom, so this would be a double room. I was thinking of doing the same here. Don't know where the bathroom would be, though. You can have a single bathroom, perhaps? The other thing I have been wondering is whether or not I can get a passage over to the other side. I'm just going to try that, just to see how high we can get, and whether there is a point where we can go onto the other side. See, this gets us to the exact same height as the roof. Oh, I could actually go over the overseer's apartment here, could I not? Yes, I could. I could do that. Could I? I couldn't go this side. But is it possible that we might be able to go sideways there? That would be useful. One of the problems is, as far as I know, we can't get on top of... Let's do a corner piece. There we have the corner. Or can we?
This is delicious.
No, it won't snap quite into position there. Although we could have roof access, which is interesting. But it means we can have some sort of passage, probably from the next floor, over to this side. And that means people can have a quicker way over. Plus, it looks like over this point, we can actually have... Oh my god, I'm not even sure we need another side. I've been so fixated on the idea of getting two floors here. I have a sneaking suspicion I've got a lot more space in this major area than I ever imagined. Which is funny, because I always was going to place the residences down there when I finally realized I had no room. But up here, I may actually have... And I may even be able to send the passage around here so it doesn't go... Basically, over the overseers. Don't want people traipsing over my bedroom. Because this is actually my bedroom. Not that it's the end of the world, I suppose. Other people have to put up with that, so you might want to be wondering why doesn't the overseer, but, what's so special about this overseer fellow anyway? Right, then in which case, seeing as I do have more rooms than I... more space than I thought, I probably will... Do the... and we're going to need doors there. Let's just check where the doors are. We want a hallway with a door. That's the four-way with doors. Now we want this one. One there, and... Come into place. One there. And we will have... ladies and gents, or something like this. And then we will have... A passage that goes around here, like so, so that there is a bit of a gap so you can't see in, and maybe I'll put a locker or two in here so people can actually store jackets and that type of thing, and then we will have 2x4 for that over there. I may have the same on the other side. Now, they'll be sharing this with the apartment down there and various others, and this is only for people who want to do something like showering, or I don't know. In fact, I don't even want to think about it. What I want to do now, though, is come up with the corridors for the rest of the place so I can... Oh, someone's training downstairs. Well done! So then I can plan things. Now, what I was thinking of doing was having a kind of open hallway. I think, right here, actually. So I need to change this to the, not halter doorway, the three-way. If I want this kind of turnaround, and I might not actually, I might get rid of this. I don't think it's absolutely necessary. And the more I think about it, the more I realize it is actually taking up some space. We'll deal with that if it's a problem in a second. So now what I want is a kind of communal room here, but I don't want it to be as closed as the rest. My problem is I don't think we're going to have. Yeah, but we've got issues like that, you see, so I can't use these pieces. I was thinking I could use pieces like this, you know, and build a place and then have a door to an apartment here and so on, but I'm going to lose this corner here. Or did I have that problem when I had the four-way? I might not have had that problem with it. No, I did. So, if I want a hallway, I'm probably going to have to do it in a very similar manner to that I've been doing so far, which is to have, for example, if I want a doorway there into that apartment, I have a doorway there, and then I have, let's have a look, something like a three-way. Or, no, actually, I want a corner there, don't I? Because I'm not going to have the door straight in. So, then I have a corner here. If I want a door into this apartment, that's if I'm going to have an apartment here. Actually, see, that's only a one. That would only give them one tiny bathroom. That would be the toilet. Mind you, if I'm having the communal bathrooms, I guess I don't need to worry too much about that. Because I was going to have a double room here. So basically two 2x2s. One as a living room, one as a double bedroom, and this is going to be for a couple. That was my thinking. So single people would have 3x2. Double people would actually have two rooms. So there's an advantage to being a couple in that you have two rooms rather than one, and that's slightly more space. But in actual fact, we save space because instead of six spaces, you take four each. But that isn't a very big bathroom, and I do think I want two for each. We could have them use the bathroom over there. That's an option, of course, and depends on how big we have this room. And then one, two, three, four. Yeah, I think I'm going to have the double bedroom that I planned there. This is going to be the bathroom, which means the hallway cannot be that big, actually. Or perhaps what I should do is actually have two family rooms there plus a single room here. I think, from the looks of things, that's what I'm going to do, because I'm going to have a single room over here. So let's change that to, do I want, probably actually another door here would help me have an apartment here, another single apartment. So we get single apartments over here and family apartments near to this door, near to this little hallway, which does actually make sense, and a double over there. That's what I'm going to try and do. Try and get the single apartments over here done first by replacing this with a four-way, like, oh god, no, I can't do that. I was going to put a door into this single apartment, right? That cannot be. No, it cannot, because of these door pieces. What can be, though, is the three-way, like so, and then another three-way, like so. And then a normal, no, it would have to be a domestic, no, not the three-way. We want the hallway to door, like so. So we'll have one apartment here. We'll have one apartment here. That is two apartments for, the, for those who can't count one plus one. You know, just helping you out a little bit. Sorry. I'm muttering to myself. This is what happens when you mutter to yourself. You just start babbling almost incoherently. Like so. That would be one apartment, and we're going to need the domestic door piece there, and then we need a corner plus an end piece. Let's do this from inside, actually. They don't want to accidentally fall off and have to... Corner, and then the standard... I'm hoping it's going to let me place the... It usually does, but sometimes it doesn't let me do this. Oh, God, no, don't do that. Don't do that. Come on. Come on. That's the that's the kitchen, isn't it? Let's have a look. What have I got in there? I can't remember what piece. Oh, I remember. This has got a... Well, let me place it there. This has got a... Yes, a bunch of furniture in it as well. So if I remove that, I'm going to probably cry a little. However, I may have no choice. Okay. Oh, well, it leaves the furniture there anyway. it's not going to want to keep that there. Go up there. Right. End cap. Can I put the end cap on this side? Yes, I can. Will you now allow me to place the kitchen piece? It was a standard corner. Will you let me do that now? Right, it lets me do it like that, which is fine. I place you back there. Yes, the overseer's kitchen has got a Nuka mixer station in it, because why not, right? I mean... I saved Nuka World, and by saved, I mean I basically killed all of the raiders that were living there. There you go. My kitchen is... Oh, God. Still in one piece, and I probably should turn the TV off, shouldn't I? Same in the apartment downstairs. Did I place doors back everywhere? I think I did. Okay. We'll just close this one because... For neatness sake... One of the lights isn't working, or I've removed one of them. Oh, whoa. Whoa. Okay, those lights don't... Those lights don't fit against the wall properly. Oh, well, that is kind of annoying. Do they fit on that one? No, they... Oh, God, does that mean all my lights upstairs are floating as well? Because that's going to annoy me. I've used more sort of lamps in this because I thought... Oh, God, they do, don't they? They float. They don't work on these walls. These walls have invisible parts to them. Okay, well, they have got to go. Yes, they do. Yeah, nice warm lights in the corner, I thought. Let's have a... There are some fancy lights. Maybe the fancy lights fit a little better in here. Just... They're not vault lights, I know. I know, I'm supposed to use vault lights in vault pieces. Some people are probably complaining as I speak. But honestly, I just don't like these in here. At all. Actually, no, I don't. So the other option is more of the lamps that stand, or is that floating? That's floating too. Okay, how about if I place you Okay, so they work better. Or is that... That's stuck inside the wall now, isn't it? That is actually stuck. Yeah, I suppose... Really? Okay, well, how about on the corners? That could. That actually works. That's not too bad, is it? I probably don't need that one. Let's just... I'm preferring that, I have to admit. But yeah, we're not having floating lights. No, we're not. What others... None of the lights float anywhere else, do they? I'm going to have to go and check everywhere now. Now, this one... Is that... Does that fit? That kind of looks like a fit. So, they fit on the corner pieces. Right, it's there. It's the indented pieces they don't fit on. On the corner pieces, they fit... Like so, but then so do all. Then I could actually fancy wall light. I can use the original ones for that. Let's have a look. Those should fit. Oh no, that's indented. They should fit there, but I kind of. The corner pieces where I've put the nice soft lights, they work. The single ones are not too bad. Actually, when it comes down to it, a little above that mark there. So if I do something like this on the side pieces, they actually hit flush. What about this corner? Do I even want a light? I mean, that's where the TV is, but you sort of... I feel like I need some kind of light in here just in case. Maybe we just put a lamp here, that you can turn it on and off when watching TV. In which case, I almost feel like you don't need that. So, like, we can light this entire place up with lanterns if we want, and it's kind of a nice soft light. Although, not there, it isn't. So, let's have a think. I mean, I can just put more. More little lights, but that seems a little... I mean, I can put these ones here to light the window area up, but honestly, that just more, if anything, turns this into a bit of a fishbowl, doesn't it? I mean, people are going to be able to see clearly when we're stood at the window. And it's just not... It doesn't match. The other lights had a kind of theme to them. Unless I use these all over, and they just don't... Let's just check upstairs as well. I'm guessing that all of the rooms are sharing the same problem. Oh no, because I've lit you with a lantern. That is a problem. Okay, missed. And here, that's been lit with a lantern. I mean, for bedrooms, to be honest with you, I prefer the lanterns anyway because it allows you to switch it off and have a dark room, which does strike me as kind of the thing you might want to do, but at the same time, I mean, you can't turn these ones off, can you? No, you can't. I don't know. I really am not sure now. Other options, of course, I could have standing lanterns on the floor here. I could have... No, not something like that. I could, of course, have... Actually, they might suit this kind of a place. I mean, if I have... I don't know. A single one. Like... So. Shining there, and... Same here. That way it's not making the bed area bright, and you can, of course... Oh, really? I can't switch those off, are you? Really? I really can't turn those off. That's... frustrating. Yes, it is. That is really quite frustrating. Not that. How about that then? That's, you're hungry from lack of food. Yeah, thanks for that. That I can activate and deactivate. Oh. It's more of a reading lamp, isn't it? It doesn't actually give any light. I can't believe I'm having to rethink all the lights. Oh god, the tailor's got the same problem as well. Yep. Alright. There you go. Well, we got a warm light in that corner, and we can have a warm light in that corner. No, that's too much, isn't it? That is actually too much. So... But I wanted a light on the... These don't fit on anything, I've noticed. You'd think they would. How about a hanging light? The other options, of course, is this, but they give off such a clean and... I don't know. Diffuse kind of light. I mean, it's not an overpowering light, but I think maybe it's the best one I've got right now. But that lantern, for example, doesn't do much then. The odd thing is that it actually works. It fits nicely against the... It just doesn't... Well, it lacks any sort of class, doesn't it? I mean, you know, I mean... It's like that. You don't really want that on your wall if you're... There's this, of course, but I don't think this is one that... It's not particularly clean looking. I've tried those. I suppose no one's really going to notice. They give off, in my opinion, a little bit of a nicer light than the fluorescent ones. Maybe a single bulb. That actually, again, looks too rusty, but it also, I don't think it suits the vault. That's the big problem. Just doesn't suit the vault. But then neither does that in a way. And a lot of it comes down to that it looks the wrong colour. But, yeah. Honestly, right now, as daft as it may seem, these are the lights we're supposed to be using. But they don't fit flush against the ceiling anyway. So you have to sort of pretend that they're hanging. There's also, okay, this one just doesn't fit well on the roofs for some odd reason. That's a fluorescent, right? I mean, let's just say, that's horrible, especially for a bedroom. Right now, the one that fits the best and gives off probably the least offensive light is the one that just, from a style perspective, completely fails. I may have to revisit this. Let's make sure they're at the same height, just to be... Yeah. Okay, and I can't turn that one off. That is... really annoying! Okay, we're gonna go for... We'll use the soft version of that one in there. So! I mean, that's enough light. It's a soft one for the bedroom, and it's a harsh one over this side. Oh god, I missed it. I suppose that will work. What is going to work downstairs? No, it's just, that does not work. That does not work. For me, this is going to be a temporary solution until I can think of something, or find something. To use instead. For now, this will be the temporary solution. I will just place these where I feel they are needed to give the sort of the light around the place that is needed. That lantern can stay on. Having it a little shadowed the TV corner of the room is... God, no, they're just too bright. They're horrible. They are. That's just... Totally ruining the style of the room. Of course, I could just go for a table lamp right at the center. Not like that. This actually is where you would probably want a hanging lantern. Now that I think about it. This is... Where are those? We don't have a chandelier, but we do have some... That's a bit too much, isn't it? Something like so. That looks... It's not quite central, but then that means the tables and chairs are not central either. Do I want the tables and chairs central? Probably. Oh god, I did a totally terrible job at getting those central, didn't I? 1, 2, 3, 4, that needs to be on that line, roughly. Yeah. Which means these need to move back a tiny bit, I think. These don't need to be perfectly aligned, because of course people don't leave chairs perfectly aligned. Alright, so... Some basic room lanterns over there work, but this over here does not. This is... I think I'm going to have to, for now, stick with... that. Could go for, I'd use the red and green ones, but they're not actually that good. That's a real mismatch of lights in here. Yes, it is. Where's the door? You didn't put a door in. Okay. That's a real mismatch of lights, but I don't think I've got much of a choice at the moment. Well, of course I've got a choice. I could have floating lights or all ugly lights. But overall, I think it kind of works as a lighting solution. How about in here? Well, that one light was enough in here. For the overseer's office, I have got one lantern in the corner there, which is doing a reasonable job. I think we'll just stick with... For now, and this is what I consider a temporary solution. We will stick with... Oh my god, I wish we need subcategories, do you know that? Definitely need subcategories. For now, I'm going to stick with something like... that. We got two lights at the side now. One at the back. It's still a bit dim, isn't it? Kind of feel like we need... It's just the wrong sort of light for this sort of room, I think. Those are at different heights. Why are those at different heights? I'm talking about the rivet points now. The rivet points are at different heights, which is extremely strange. Okay, what just happened? Oh, right, for some reason? Has my mouse died? No. It decided to toggle me into the strafe mode. I don't know why. Okay, so... I mean, it's bad. It is. It's bad, but if we want this room to be well lit, and this is an office, we'll have to have that for now. But that is... Well, it's horrible. Yes, it is. Okay, and of course, the tailor is using the same room set, which means that she... I believe it's a she. She is probably suffering the same... Oh, no! No, you're not there! Because it's a corner. They do okay in corner pieces. They work in corner pieces. So, if we just illuminate the corner really well... you see, it's... Apart from the one that was there, that actually works okay. Maybe put one over there as well. Okay, right, there you go. I've fixed the lighting problem. I can't believe I just got that distracted by... the horrible lights.
This is delicious.
That all started because I was making an apartment here. Yes, that's right. An apartment here, and then having a... Yeah, right. So, do I want to do the lights now and the furniture now, or do I want to do all of the apartments first? I think What I should do is sort the apartment layouts first, just in case I have to do that kind of thing again, where I remove things for end caps and, you know, basically have to undo a lot of stuff. So putting furniture and lights in is probably a bad idea at the moment. But there you go. That is an apartment up here. We're then going to have another apartment like so. Oh, this person will only get a one square bathroom. And I'm preferring the idea of the two square bathroom, you know, toilet, sink, plus maybe some towel racks, and then future expansion space for shower if they ever get one. I kind of want to stick with that, so that would mean actually... Well, I'll tell you what, why don't we continue to build up... I am going to have bathrooms here, so it's whether or not it makes that big a difference. It probably won't, but... Let's build the bathroom pieces right now, and I've already placed the... Oh, we need end pieces? We're going to need end pieces, because I'm going to use... Oh, end pieces never work. It never works. Look. Oh, God. It always does that. That's just... Yeah, no. Okay, let's have a think. How can I do that and have it work? Simple fact of the matter is I will not get that to work. The using those end pieces to connect to other domestic units always causes flicker. There seems to be no way around it. It doesn't seem to matter what order you do the building in. It's always the same. So the way around this is not perfect. We only have one door. And this is actually how a lot of toilets do it anyway. We have like that. And then we place the end pieces like so. And then we go to the clinic piece. What's that noise? Oh, it's the people... Food. It's the food people! That's the I wonder what the hell was going on. Right, so... See, that doesn't get flicker. If you do rooms to the domestic end caps... he says, and then we get flicker on one of them. The way to fix it usually is to simply... he's... Look at this. Making a complete liar out of me, isn't it? Okay. Awesome. Just what I needed. So that piece doesn't have flicker. But... Burn it. That's the one I actually want. And that has flicker. That has horrible flicker. And that does not. Well, that's insane. Yes, it is. That is insane. But it's an insanity that I can work with. Oh. Yeah, it's an insanity I can work with. But I'll need a four-way then, because then this is... We don't want a we don't actually want that T now, do we? No, we actually want a straight piece. See, the way around that one is to just go for a four-way right here. And of course I'll have to get rid of the door first. I place a four-way here and hope like hell I didn't get flicker here now. Nope. And then a standard piece. Okay, come on, come on. here, then a corner. Here. Now, this is a little closer to the... I guess we're going to make that the gents. I don't think it matters too much. This is a little closer to... It's probably easier out there. A little closer to the... Come on, snap. Thank you. It's a little closer to this apartment than I wanted. Not that it makes a huge difference, but, you know... Essentially, this is going to be... Ladies and gents rooms. That is so weird, isn't it? How weird is that? I mean, you can have an end piece one way and one way only without getting flicker. Just... What do you bet I'm going to get the flicker right now? It's like, it does not matter which actual side you do. It's this particular room is going to have flicker whether you like it or not. Nope, there you go. It's actually... that's fine. So, okay, let's finish these two rooms off. Okay, so we've now got a couple of rooms set up for communal ablutions, when we finally find some actual ablutions. I'm wondering whether I... No, that's the thing. I can't actually put doors here. That is the big problem. I cannot put a door here without it causing shimmer because of the end cap problem. I am hungry, I think. Hungry, thirsty. Actually, I need to check with the traders. I haven't done the traders thing today. Let's have a look. I mean, it does mean whoever comes in and out of here... It's going to be glancing in there, but at least they're glancing in at an angle where they should only see that wall. So hopefully there's a certain edge of privacy. That is the communal ablutions, probably the men's, that will be the ladies. And anyone who walks down here will assume to be the correct gender. So there's that. That is now sorted. I've gone the wrong way. And... I'm going to have a room here, a 4x2, plus a two-way. Okay, let's start with the end cap. I am famished from lack of food, so I should probably sort that out before I start dying. This could work. I think it's a little pokier than I imagined it in my mind. I mean, we've got a table, they've got music, they've got a TV. I do prefer that TV. But honestly, I think this is... not exactly how I imagined it. Now, the other thought I had was in this spot, I could actually have a 3x3 room here. And it's just one big room, two beds... and, you know, a bunch of stuff like so. And they could just live like that. Which is an option. And then, of course, they still get the bathroom. It would be the same size. I think I might have a variety of layouts just for the fun of it, to be honest. I think now that I'm giving it some consideration... actually having multiple layouts is the way to go. I'm also thinking I should... Let's have a think. No, that's 2x2. That's probably the right way to go here. So, to get the 3x3 layout, I would have to remove this corner here and just have it turn right here, which is perfectly fine. Not a problem with that. And it would give me... that. You know what? I am gonna not shoot things. I am going to do that. I'm gonna try that out for this space. But before I do that, I should probably sort out the food situation. And I think that means I have to go and... I really have to fix this corner, don't I?